What is going on? I hope you're staying safe and playing lots of video games. Today we're going to be looking at Steambot Chronicles Battle Tournament on the Sony PSP. The game starts out with the main character traveling to Orion City by a giant ship. The city is steampunk themed and is the place where you will be spending most of your time in the game. You can choose the gender for the main protagonists and name them, but there is no cosmetic customization, however, which was disappointing for someone who enjoys being a fashionista in regards to video game character cosmetics. I like to dress them up. I like to put what I want on them. I like to customize them. Not gonna lie, I just usually put a disgusting mohawk on them. So you learn that the main character is going to the city to compete in the Colosseum, a battle arena where big robot mechs duke it out. You also meet a girl when you first arrived named Venus, who helps you out by repairing your mech that was damaged when you fought off a bandit that was harassing her. And I have to say, your character's got game. Your character's got game. I mean, he just arrives in the city, and not but 5 minutes later, he meets this girl that sticks with him throughout the entire game. So after she takes you to her garage to fix this mech that also, by the way, you just obtain as soon as you get to the city. I don't really know how that happened. It just happens. You just have a mech right when you get there waiting for you. So she takes you to the repair shop. You repair up your mech, and later on you actually encounter more bandits and they steal this pendant that Venus owns, which obviously it held a lot of value to her. She's very upset that she lost it. So once you get some of the opening dialogue done, you will start completing jobs that various residents in and out of the city have requested. Alongside of completing jobs, you'll have the freedom to attempt to rank up your status as a badass mech fighter, or Trotmobile as they're called in the game. I just want to say the voice acting in this game is fantastic. It plays out like a graphic novel and I really enjoyed it. Even without any 3D cutscenes, instead it's just 2D hand-drawn characters with dialogue boxes, but the performances here were very convincing. They really convince you that they're really feeling these emotions. I was impressed at how well executed the voice lines were for the most part. And don't get me wrong, there's some silliness to the game for sure. This game also had a great finale to the story. Several big plot reveals happen at the end, and there are several different endings depending on what dialogue you choose for your character. The dialogue choices were entertaining, although they didn't change the plot drastically during the game except for at the ending. It really matters what you choose to say because it will determine how the ending will turn out. So, the downside to the story in this game is that although it starts out very strong, throughout the middle of the game, there was not a lot of story unfolding, to the point where me and some of my stream viewers were confused when later on in the game it started finishing up the story, and we were just kind of like, wait, hold on, what's happening? I've been so focused on jobs and fighting in the Colosseum. Oh yeah, Venus's pendant got stolen, I think. So there are 34 jobs, to my knowledge, and they can get more repetitive than the chorus of a One Direction song. Okay, that was terrible. I'm sorry. That was bad. Okay, how about they get more repetitive than the plot of every Spider-Man movie ever? That was still an insult to a franchise I love, but I'm going with it, okay? Spider-Man plot, yes. Each time you complete a job, you will earn cash and also what are called fame points, which allow you to enter fights in the Colosseum. Fighting in the Colosseum is a pretty nice change of pace from completing jobs, and you can do them whenever you want, which is nice. One of the things that actually had me interested in this game was what was going on with some of the characters, some of the NPCs. Now, don't get me wrong, most of them are just insignificant. The names that they gave these characters are hilarious, by the way. But going back to the main characters, the main NPCs that you're helping out with jobs and things like that, you'll see relationships develop with the people of Orion City as you help them, which was pretty fun. For example, there was this city girl that liked this farmer, and I kept wanting them to ask each other out, and eventually the farmer got a ring for the city girl to ask her to marry him. So I feel like they put a lot into the story of the NPCs, and I enjoyed watching certain ones unfold. Another huge change of pace is what I call the dungeon, which in the game is called the Farmost Ruins. It becomes available after completing several jobs. This is where the game goes full Dark Souls, full Bloodborne, full Cuphead on your ass. I had a lot of fun making sure my mech was ready for this quest. That was another feature in this game that kept me engaged with the character's progress. Upgrading your trot, that is, but I'll touch a little bit on that later. I want to finish talking about this beefcake dungeon. This thing was massive. Luckily, I had friends in my chat to help me prepare for it, but basically it's 10 levels of dungeon crawling madness. You're tasked with finding one key and one legendary item per floor. Each key is held by a random enemy, and each legendary piece is hidden in one of the many treasure chests scattered throughout the floors. This becomes a real challenge because there's no health in this entire Atlantis of a dungeon. So this dungeon will train you very well for how to deal with all the enemies because it constantly springs enemies on you of different kinds. Don't get me wrong, there's not a ton, but there are a good variety of enemies in this dungeon, and going through it really just makes you get your chops, right? Like, after this dungeon, I was ready for basically any other quest. I mean, fighting trots is a different thing, but enemies during jobs, they were just like nothing after this dungeon. So it was very difficult. It was very kind of fun to just go through. Not to mention, in this game, you have a set amount of fuel for your trot, and your weapons degrade as you use them, and they're gonna need repairs. You can find fuel and money, but there's no way to repair your trot in this dungeon either. So the dungeon will take at least an hour, probably more. I think it took me a couple hours to beat. It was so rewarding once I did finally conquer it though. I felt fantastic for making it through. I was given this giant awesome sword called the Excalibur, which was so dope. It was far more powerful than any of my other weapons at the time, which made beating the dungeon really worth it. Also, not a bad bonus when you beat the dungeon is that you find tons of cash during your playthrough, so you'll most likely come out a lot more rich. I do wish that this game had more items to collect in it. For example, I finished the game and only got two items, a voucher for free repairs and homemade jam from a quest that is just unusable. You can't do anything with it. It would have been cool to find items on the field that enemies would drop. I mean, they do drop, like I said, money, ammunition, fuel for your trot. They do drop those, but it would have been nice to have a farming system where you could just grind for better weapons, I guess. And I was gonna say it would be really nice to find something that heals you on the field, which is absolutely true, but I think they kind of designed this game around not finding health on the field. I think that actually is one very unique feature to this game that actually worked. I mean, going through that dungeon, part of what the heart-throbbing just anxiety was that you couldn't find any health, and that goes for the jobs, you know. Anytime you're out on the field, you're not gonna find health just by killing an enemy. It's not gonna happen. So you have to always make sure you're on top of your game and healed up before you start a quest, which is, like I said, pretty unique. Another interesting thing in this game is that you won't gain any EXP. It would have been cool to gain EXP points, but I just feel like this game gives you enough progress with your mech and, you know, finding money, the grind of upgrading your mech, that EXP as a form of progression just wasn't missed very much for me personally. All right, I'm almost done talking about the jobs, but I just want to let you know that there are also two different types of jobs that you have. So you have ones that are out there on the field. Like I said, you're going to be collecting wood and harvesting like berries for people and bringing them back to the city, and harvesting like wine and bringing it back to the city, harvesting just all kinds of different stuff. And then you have the ones that are in the city where you don't have to use your trot to go out on the field. And it's just, you're going to be talking to the townsfolk and helping them out. There was like a milk delivery quest where you just deliver everybody's milk for them. And there's like a newspaper quest, I believe, and just different little fun things like that, which also are pretty cool for the NPCs. They're not very bland. They're actually pretty funny to read the dialogue. So I didn't mind the quests, the jobs that were in the city. I thought they were pretty fun. So I've covered jobs. Now I want to talk about the Colosseum, where you rank up and earn cash. Basically, you'll be pitted in a caged fighting match against AI mechs, all with different abilities because they have different weapons equipped. This is where you'll get practice for controlling your mech, which admittedly is quite clunky, but I found that after I practiced, controlling my trot was actually pretty fun. I also had a lot of fun fighting my way up through the ranks. However, once I did hit the top level, which is A rank, the final story quest is unlocked, which is great. But what bothers me is that once you beat A rank, you get promoted to S rank, but there's really no more battles in S rank, so I just felt like there should really be more battles unlocked after you hit S rank. I would say the downsides to the gameplay is that there really aren't many places to explore. Most of the game takes place in about five areas: Orient City, the Forest, the Valley, the Snowy Peaks, and the Volcano. All of which look pretty good graphically, and they have plenty of enemies and it's pretty challenging. But again, some people may be disappointed by the size of the game. However, personally, it didn't really bother me. I'm pretty used to small PSP games. One of the fun things about the gameplay was saving up money to upgrade your trot. I was really excited to obtain new homing missile launchers, giant bazookas, rapid-fire guns, and other various weapons as I progressed. And also, you have the ability to upgrade each part of your trot: your HP, carrying capacity, attack power, elemental resistances, among others. Also, I really like how you can swap the back parts of your trot for certain jobs, like collecting wine in a barrel, like I mentioned earlier, gathering wood on a flatbed, or taking people for a ride to see the destination of choice in a little piggyback carriage. I did want to mention that the music was also really well done. With as much time that I spent in the city, I was surprised that the music didn't get on my nerves and was actually pretty enjoyable. I don't think that this game has much replayability once you beat it and finish up all the jobs. There's not much more to do. However, I would replay it in the future, just from scratch. This was an adorable little hidden gem, and I mean hidden gem. This game is so obscure that I had trouble finding information online about it. Obviously some people know about it, but yeah, I'd be willing to bet that not a lot of people besides like hardcore PSP enthusiasts know about it. Speaking of which, if you are a PSP enthusiast and or collector, this game is absolutely worth checking out if you haven't already. The average time to beat it is about 15 hours, possibly a bit more if you plan on completing all the jobs available. I'm gonna give Steambot Chronicles a 67 out of 100. I don't know why I switched to that system, but I thought it was better than 1 through 10. So we're going the Metacritic route, and I don't know why 67, that was popped into my head, and it seems perfect for this game for me. I don't know. I would have given it higher, but I feel like it just lacks size, really. It's a very tightly packed game. However, if you don't mind the grinding, which I loved in it, I would have given it a higher score if it was just a little bit bigger for your average, you know, RPG player. That's gonna do it for this review. I do want to give my usual comment shout out. So this is the part of the video where I just give anybody that commented on my channel, on my videos, just want to give you a little comment shout out and say thank you for, you know, commenting and letting me know what you thought. It's really interesting to see what people have to say. And also I'm hoping that it gets you to comment more, because I want more comments on my videos, I'm not gonna lie. So yeah, definitely leave a comment and you might get a comment shout out in the end of one of my videos. Also, if you're interested in this hidden gem, definitely go check out my streams of it on my channel. It will give you a more hands-on look at the game. Also, make yourself a bowl of cereal, play some Genshin Impact, and level up that like button. Look how low level it is. It needs some EXP gains. I'm almost at 1,000 subscribers, so if you want to be a part of the Cheetos Dust on the Fingers PSP gaming squad, feel free to subscribe. Also, I just wanted to give a quick update on my plans, cheesiness aside, which is more PSP game streams and more reviews to come. I've got a couple different, genres that I want to incorporate with the PSP, and I think it'll be really exciting. So yes, definitely hit the bell as well. With all that being said though, you've been a fantastic viewer. Thank you so much. If you've made it this far, you're a real MVP. Thank you. Thank you so much. That being said though, I will see you in the next video. Peace.